Today I have Ted Wallace, who runs physical networking and data center build out for OCI. Welcome, Ted.
Thanks, Vinay. Good to be here.
You have been doing multiple roles within OCI. And today, how do you describe what you do at OCI?
My job at OCI is to make sure that OCI's infrastructure and foundations are where it needs to be, when it needs to be, so that customers can use OCI wherever they want.
Great. With that, in the last 4 weeks alone, we have built 4 regions, starting with South Korea, Tokyo in Japan, Mumbai, India, and São Paulo in South America. How did you guys do it?
Well, we do that with a lot of software development, a lot of automation, and a lot of coordination. From the beginning, we knew we wanted to launch a lot of regions and to be where our customers wanted us to be. And in order to do that, you need to have a mechanism where every region's not this artisanal thing that's handcrafted. Instead, what you need to do is use automation and software to be able to repeatedly deploy things like a factory. Mm-hmm. And that's what we've built over the past few years.
Great. Yeah, because there are a lot of moving parts here, right? You need to acquire a data center. You need to automate the heck out of all the services that we deploy. In fact, we introduce 10 to 15 new services every quarter, so you need to consider that into the account. So the complexity can only increase going forward. And you know, as we talk about it externally, we are going to announce or launch one region every month for the next 15 months. That's mind-boggling. Tell me, how are you going to do it going forward?
Well, we're going to do it through relentless automation.
Yeah.
Our objective is to make sure that all of the developers at OCI have the ability to deploy their software where they need to as quickly as possible.
Yeah.
And so by focusing on automation that enables them to be focused on writing new software and new features for customers instead of the sort of the grunge of deploying software out to new regions, it helps us actually launch a lot of regions. It helps the software developers focus what they want. And it gives OCI customers sort of the best of both worlds. They get what they want, where they want it, and they get new features at an amazing rate.
Great. In addition to building new regions, we're also expanding our existing regions all the time, mm-hmm. right? So what are the challenges that are different in expansion rather than building a new region?
The primary difference in expansion versus building a new region is having to forecast and understand where you might need that space. It gets complicated if you start to add to an existing region in lots of little increments, mm-hmm. Because suddenly the connective tissue between those increments becomes very complicated. So being able to think clearly and accurately about what our future holds, and so having the right base infrastructure in place to help that smoothly grow is really critical to being able to grow without causing problems.
Got it. So I also heard things like, hey, look, dock to usage, dock to revenue is something you guys have really worked hard on. Can you tell more about it?
Yes, getting things shipped and installed and available to customers very quickly is super important. On the one hand, we want to have capacity for customers whenever they want it. Another is we want to manage our costs carefully. It'd be very easy mm-hmm. and very expensive to have, you know, reams of Exadata filling up a hall and not being used.
Yeah, you wish, yeah.
Yeah, that would be great. Turns out that wastes a lot of money. So instead, we have to be very, very good at manufacturing the gear, putting it on shipping, getting it to the data center, and then from the data center, getting it live. So our standard compute rack went from about 30 days to under 24 hours.
Oh, fantastic.
And our Exadata racks take a couple weeks.
So I also understand, Ted, some of our regions that we built initially in large markets, like in North America and EMEA, have a construct of at least 3 data centers that form a region. We call them as availability domains. Gives you more flexibility in application deployment for availability. But our newer regions have single AD or single data center, as we call it. Why do you think we took this approach?
Well, as it turns out, not every customer wants to be in one of those larger regions based on where they are, mm-hmm. Or they may not value what the multiple ADs give from a geographic standpoint. So we created the one AD region as a way to launch into more jurisdictions, more countries, more regions more quickly.
More quickly, yeah.
So that we could get our foot in the door and get something to customers fast. Customers, in addition to getting that, they have the ability to use very similar constructs that the multi-ADs give you using fault domains, where we help customers make sure that if they have, say, 2 or 3 computers, that it's not on the same rack or, you know, in the same part of the network, so that if there's a failure that affects one of the machines, it won't affect one of the other machines.
Got it. So in that context, Ted, in North America and EMEA, mm-hmm. even though I have a 3AD regions, I have a second region for DR capability.
Yep.
So are you saying we'll be the first cloud to have a DR in every region that we go?
I expect to have two regions in every country in the world eventually.
That's fantastic.
And the very reason is I want to make sure that our customers have the ability to have their region nearby that's low latency and is in their local jurisdiction, and to have DR far enough away that they feel comfortable that they've got business continuity without any trouble.
Great. So this makes me think you can build regions very quickly. You can roll out regions faster than I have ever seen do in the cloud world. If a large customer outside of the Gov space comes to you and say, I need a region for me, can you build one? Can you?
Of course. So everything that we do to make it possible to build a region for customers that's for government customers that makes it special for governments, we can do that same thing for a commercial customer and give them the same quality experience that's being run by OCI on their behalf. It's just a region with one customer.
Great. So that means conceptually, it will look like a region. I'm the only customer in that region. If I choose to, can I use other public regions which are connected?
Of course, yes. Our objective would be, although with customers it may depend, like our objective would be to ensure that that region, that dedicated region for a customer, has good access either to our backbone, if that's what a customer wants, or simply good internet access that they could use to create connectivity to our public cloud.
Great. I think that's the first time I've heard any cloud provider talk about it, building a very sophisticated cloud services only for them. So I'm looking forward to engaging with customers with this message soon. We are Oracle. We are not only building magical software for customers, but we traditionally own a lot of our hardware investments, right?
Yes.
Whether it's x86 or Spark. And if you think about it, as an Oracle stack, we have direct access to our hardware engineering team, which can design. We also have direct access to our supply chain, which is very unique in the cloud world, where most of the large-scale providers have to rely on the external OEMs. Mm-hmm. How is that helping us get better?
It helps us in a bunch of ways. We expect the hardware that runs Oracle databases to be bulletproof. And that same hardware and that same opinion about how it should work cascades down through all the hardware that we deploy in our data centers. As a result, I think customers get a higher quality machine than they can get it at some of these other locations by using Oracle hardware, by using OCI. The added advantage is that with working closely with both hardware development and supply chain, we can walk down the hall and have a conversation for them about what works best for our cloud, how to make things move more quickly for our cloud, how to think ahead about what's coming from a GPU standpoint or some new hardware, so that we can get ahead of the demand and ensure that we have what our customers need as soon as they need it.
Great. My last question. Mm-hmm. If you have a magic prediction of how the regions and the story for customers is going to evolve from your point of view for OCI, what would that be?
I think over the next several years, Oracle and OCI are going to continue launching regions everywhere we possibly can, so that customers can have access to OCI's awesome capabilities without having to cross international borders or large latency distances. So I mentioned earlier that I think I expect to have two regions in every country. I expect to have more than two regions in every country because I expect large companies to want their own private regions.
Yeah.
So I expect to have hundreds of regions in the not too distant future.
Can't wait.
Yeah, it's going to be great.
Thank you, Ted.
Cheers.